In today's video, we are looking at Chinua Achebe, widely known as the father of the African novel in English. Achebe is one of the most significant writers to emerge from contemporary Africa, with a literary vision that has profoundly influenced the form and content of modern African literature. His writings are among the first in English to present an intimate and authentic rendering of African culture. This brings us to major theme of Achebe's writing, that is, social and psychological impact of European imperialism on indigenous African societies, particularly with respect to a distinctly African consciousness in the 20th century. A very good example of this may be seen in his first novel, Things Fall Apart, which many critics have proclaimed a classic of modern African fiction. Reviewers have also praised his novels for their insightful interpretation of African history as well as balanced examination of contemporary African politics and society. Scholars commend Achebe's innovative fusion of folklore, proverbs and idioms from his native Igbo tribe with Western political ideologies and Christian doctrines. Going back to his early days, we see Chinua Achebe was born in 1930 in Ojidi, Anambra, Nigeria. He was born as Albert Chinua Lumugu Achebe to Isaiah Okafo Achebe and Zenith Ilok Bunum and had 5 surviving siblings. His parents had stopped practicing their traditional religion and had converted to Christianity. Therefore, as a young boy, Achebe was exposed to a combination of traditionalism as well as Christian influence. Storytelling was a part of the rich Nigerian tradition, and he grew up listening to the stories told by his family members. He joined St. Philip's Central School in 1936. He was a very bright student and appreciated by his teachers. He continued his education at Government College in Umuahia before enrolling in 1948 in the first class at the newly established University College in Ibadan, run by the University of London. Here, he was also given a scholarship to study medicine. However, his interest was not in medicine and he shifted to study English, history and theology and lost his scholarship in the process. Then, he started writing while at the university and made his debut as the author with his article Polar Undergraduate in the University Herald in 1950. He also wrote numerous other stories, essays and letters during this time and finally graduating from the college in 1953. Further, in the second innings of his life, we see his career. We see that he started his career working as a teacher at a small school for 4 months. Here, he encouraged his student to develop a reading habit. After this, in 1945, he began a 12-year stint as producer for the Nigerian broadcasting company NBC in Lagos, the capital of Nigeria. His job was to prepare script for oral delivery. His experience over here helped him in writing realistic dialogues later on in his writing career. During these years, Achebe also began researching and writing his most famous novel, Things Fall Apart. Meanwhile, he was appointed at the staff school run by the British Broadcasting Corporation, that is BBC, in 1956. And this gave him the chance to go to London and get feedback on the novel he was working on. After editing and revising his novel, he sent it to London Company for publishing. His debut novel, Things Fall Apart, was released in 1958. The work won him a nomination for the prestigious Booker Prize. He followed this with 3 other novels: No Longer at Ease in 1960, Arrow of God in 1964, and A Man of the People in 1966. In between, he became the director of external broadcasting at the NBS and helped to create the Voice of Nigerian network. Then, he attended an executive conference of African writers in English in Uganda, where he met other prominent writers from around the world, including Kofi Awoonor, Wole Soyinka, and Langston Hughes. By 1966, however, Nigeria's political climate has worsened, eventually deteriorating into a civil war that has lasted 30 months. Achebe quit his position at NBC and moved to the eastern region of Nigeria, where he began a research fellow and later a professor of English at the University of Nigeria in 1976. And this is how he looked in 1976. After the war ended, Achebe accepted a series of visiting professorships in the United States, where he founded and edited the African literary journal Okaik, a Nigerian journal of new writing, and published Mourning Yet on Creation Day in 1975, a collection of literary and political essays written between 1962 and 1973. By the early 1980s, Achebe was actively involved in Nigerian politics, serving first as the Deputy National President of the People's Redemption Party and later as President of the Town Union in his homeland of OGD. During that time, he also issued a polemical commentary on Nigerian leadership, The Trouble with Nigeria, in 1983. And in 1987, Achebe published Ant Hills of the Savannah, about a military coup in a fictional African land. In 1990, he was involved in a tragic car accident that left him paralyzed from waist below. The disability, however, could not demoralize the courageous writer, and he became professor of languages and literature at Bard College in New York. In 2000, he published Home and Exile, a series of reflective essays on his life and work. Turning towards his awards and achievement, we see in 2002, he won German Booksellers Peace Prize. He was presented the Man Booker International Prize in 2007 for his literary career. And the then judge, Nadine Godemer, called him the father of modern African literature at the award ceremony. He also won the Dorothy and Lillian Gish Prize in 2010. The annual prize is given to a man or woman who has made an outstanding contribution to the beauty of the world and to mankind's enjoyment and understanding of life. Surprisingly, he has received over 30 honorary degrees from universities all over the world. Despite his global standing and international renown, Achebe never received the Nobel Prize for Literature, which some, particularly Nigerians, viewed as unjust. When he was asked by a reporter for Quality Weekly that how he felt about never winning a Nobel Prize, he replied, "My position is that the Nobel Prize is important, but it is a European prize. It's not an African prize. Literature is not a heavyweight championship. Nigerians may think, you know, this man has been knocked out. It's nothing to do with that." Now, a major crux of his life was his personal life. In the real life, he married Christy Okoli in 1961 and had 4 children. He went on to become a grandfather of 6. Lastly, he died after an illness in 2013 and was buried in the hometown of OGD. Now, the writings of Chinua Achebe. What I have done is, along with the slides in the video, I have already made Achebe's writings available in the PDF on the Telegram channel at the English Cherry. Or just scan the QR code on your screen to get there. So don't forget to check it out. And that is it for today's video. Thank you for listening.